Kumar, the Managing Director and CEO of Ricoh India, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining us, Mr. Kumar. And could you take us through the product, the market size for this product, and what is the incremental sales that you are looking at with this product?
Okay, so this is a web-based tax solution which is hosted on Ricoh Cloud, and it's going to change the way the medical imaging works in India in the healthcare segment. So to begin with, this is a solution which will drastically improve the accessibility of medical images by all stakeholders. And when we speak of stakeholders, we talk about the patients, the consultants, the radiologists, and the hospitals. Also, it will reduce the cost of healthcare in two ways. First is that it's going to eliminate the need of clinical medical images. The second one is going to make this solution more affordable. In the sense that this works on a SaaS model, it's on a subscription model and does not involve any capital investment. Also, it's going to improve the penetration of healthcare in penetration of technology, in healthcare by taking the medical clinical quality far ahead. And also, this is intraoperable, so the patients will be able to use this technology on their tablets, on their laptops, on their mobiles. And in that sense, the patients also will have a much greater freedom of choice when it comes to choosing their consultants whom they want to go to for their diagnosis. Also, this is a solution which very seamlessly integrates with the hospital information system and the radiology information system. So in that sense, it's completely within the system of information technology which any hospital may follow.
Okay. Hi, Mr. Kumar. Just to add a few financials about Picasso. So one, what is the kind of money which you spend in developing this product? Then what is going to be the advertising and marketing spend that you envisage? And thirdly, what is the kind of revenue that you expect from this product in FY16 as well as in FY17, which will be your first full year of operations?
As of now, we estimate the market for this product to be roughly about 50 crore rupees. However, this is on the basis of the segment in which this product is currently accessible. We see a huge future of tax in the Indian market, and with this technology now becoming more accessible and more affordable, we expect this market to grow many folds. So, what is 50 crores today could exponentially grow in the times to come. So far as our cost, marketing cost and promotion this product is concerned, we are very aggressively marketing all our product solutions and services. And we are going to be pitching in Picasso also and all the marketing related initiatives which we carry out.
Right. Should you go into the market launches of the company? Last year, your other income came at 17 crore versus about 2 crore, which will increase the profit as well. So, could you explain the other income component from there as well?
Yeah, so I will not dwell too much into other income because as compared to the total 1,637 crore rupees that the turnover that we posted last year, 17 crore is in the period. But I would like to give you a much broader picture of what we did last year. So as you would be aware, using the three business lines of imaging, IT services and communications on one axis and using the five specific industry verticals that we are focused upon, which is healthcare, education, manufacturing, GSSI, and certain other strategic business verticals, we have been able to create a metrics-based business approach whereby we are able to come up with customized solutions to meet specific needs of customers across each of the industry verticals. This is what is helping us to grow our business, this is what is helping us to grow our top line, and this is what is helping us to make deeper penetration into the Indian market. So today we do not operate in any one industry, so to say. We operate across the entire market, and which is what speaks about our desire to reach out to customers in every part of the country, and this is what is making us expand our business like never before.
Okay. Very recently, maybe about 2 months ago, you had indicated that the company is expanding into UK. You have already won 150 crore of projects from the Uttar Pradesh government. Any other state government projects that you've had recently or are you likely to win? And, have you faced any challenges in terms of receivables from any government of India projects?
There are several state government projects that we are executing. So we are very actively engaged with the central government as well as with the state government. UP, of course, is one state that we are working in. Besides UP, we are also very actively present in the states of Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, and many other states, so to speak. We also, in fact, this you might already be aware of now, in about 6 months since we won the order to modernize the rural post offices in India under green energy backfill department of sports. There are many orders where currently we are participating, but a recent order that we won was in Delhi. This was an ICT order for the state of Delhi, for Delhi schools. And on your point regarding the challenges that we might be facing in collecting our receivables, we have not yet faced any such challenge, so to say. So we are being very careful because we do understand that that's very important criteria that one has to bear in mind while doing business. So we are very heavily focused on ensuring that we do not make any debt so far as our receivables are
concerned. Could you also give us a segmental breakdown of the revenue growth that you are looking into in FY16 from your goods and your services business, considering that we have been growing at 56% and we do maintain that we will continue to grow at these levels?
Yes. So, in fact, we have been growing at the rate of 55% to 60% CAGR, and that is a growth rate which we expect to continue with, in fact, even improve upon it in the times to come. And so far as your question with respect to the split of that between the goods and services is concerned, I would say goods and the hardware constitute about 65% of the total business, whereas roughly about 1/3 of it comes from the services part.
All right, we'll leave it at that. We'll just take a short break as an opportunity.